Philip Lakin, empowering ops professionals that use no code with operator. He seems like a pretty good guy to connect with. I'm going to connect with him. Zane Khan, the AI guy. Ooh, I like AI. I'm going to connect with this guy for sure. Alex Brogan, exploring how to get better at the game of life. Well, I need to hear what he has to say, so I'm going to connect with him also. Oh, hi. I was just going through my process of finding people to connect with on LinkedIn. See, what I do is I use Bardeen. This right here is a Bardeen screen, and this is a playbook that scrapes the information off of a LinkedIn profile, and then I send that over to make.com, where I use ChatGPT AI to create a personalized connection note, which I'll use when I connect with that person. And then I save this to Monday as a task, which I'll go back later and batch invite people to connect with me on LinkedIn. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do all of this with Bardeen and with Make. Don't worry, it's not very complicated at all. And I'm going to show you how to do this and connect it to Monday. You could connect it to Google Sheets if you want, to Notion, to ClickUp, whatever you want. I just happen to be using Monday to track my tasks for connections. So let's jump into Bardeen and see what that looks like. But before we do, I want to say my name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation to their business. I also want to invite you to join my newsletter, where I send it out every Tuesday. There's a link down in the description to find that and subscribe. And I would appreciate it if you hit the like button and consider subscribing to my channel, because I create stuff like this on a weekly basis. You can sign up for Bardeen at bardeen.ai. What this is an AI automation extension for the Chrome browser. So this works inside of Chrome, and this does very different things than Make does. For example, scraping websites is one of the amazing things Bardeen does very well, and it does it on your local computer level, not out in the cloud. So to set up an automation, I click on my Bardeen link right here, and I'm going to create an automation. I'm going to look for scrape data on an active tab, and then I'm going to type LinkedIn, and the one I want is LinkedIn profile by Bardeen. You don't have to train Bardeen to scrape the LinkedIn profile. It's already there for you. So we've added our trigger here, and this is pretty much ready to go. We don't have to do anything with that. I'm going to turn show result off, because otherwise it pops up a box with a bunch of details, which we really don't need. Okay, the next thing we want to do is we want to click here. I want new action, and I'm going to type post. Send HTTP post request. And so now I need to go over to Make and create a webhook that we will use to send our data from Bardeen over to Make. So I'm over here in Make, and I've clicked new scenario. I'm going to give this a name. The first thing we're going to do here is type webhooks, custom webhook. And I like to name these the same name as my scenario. So I'm going to click add. I'm going to paste that right here and hit save. Now I'm going to copy the address to clipboard. Now we're going to go back over to Bardeen, and this is the URL they want. And you paste it, and then it's going to show it below, and you just have to click on the one below. Next, we're going to click add columns, and we're going to give it a name. We're going to call it LinkedIn profile, and we want that to be a URL. And then you're going to click the check here. And then we're going to go back and map this. So we're going to scrape the data on the active tab. Right here is the URL. So that's the URL of the tab. Next, we're going to add a column. Next, we want to do headline. This is the LinkedIn headline. That can be a string. We're going to click the check and go back here and map that. Here's the headline. Next, we're going to add a column. And we're going to do about. This is the long about section, which has got a lot of great stuff in it. And we're going to do a string. That is fine. This can be a long string. Click the check and go over here and look for about. Right there's the about. Add a column, and we want the name. That's a string. Map the name. You can search here for it. There it is. So we are done with this. What's going to happen is when this step runs, it's going to send this data over to our make webhook. So let's hit done there. And done. And we're going to name our automation. All right, next we need to complete our make scenario. So we're done here. Next we need to do OpenAI. There's OpenAI. And we want to create a compilation. And I already have a connection. If you don't have a connection yet, you're going to have to click add and put an API key in from your ChatGPT account. Again, your account, you have to create billing on the API side, not on the chat side of your ChatGPT account. Create a chat compilation. That's correct. I'm going to use ChatGPT-4 and I'm going to add a message. And the role is going to be system. So I've pasted my ChatGPT prompt in here and I've got some items. There's the headline and the about and the name. So I'm going to have to run this first step to get that data so we can map that. So I'm going to say run this module only. Then I'm going to go back here to LinkedIn. We're going to click the Bardeen and then we're going to click this right here. All right. So here's our data, LinkedIn profile link, headline, about, and the name did not get mapped right. So we're going to go back to Bardeen just in case that happens. And I'm over here. I'm going to edit this. Let's go back over here and map this. Scroll down here to name so we get it right. There we are. Done. Done. Sometimes we don't get it right the first time, and that's all right. So let's retest that. Let's run this. Click on that right there. All right. We got it. Everything came through. Fabio's name came through right there. All right. So now we're going to map our ChatGPT. So we're going to say this text headline, do headline, and I will put this prompt in the description of the video so you can copy and paste it. You might need to tweak it for your needs, but it should be hopefully pretty close. There's the about, and there is their name. I'm going to hit OK. Now, the next step, we're going to add our item to Monday. Like I said, you can add it to anything you want, ClickUp, Google Sheets, Notion, whatever you'd like to do. All right, I've selected my connection. Again, any of these that you're using for the first time, you'll have to click add to add a connection and authenticate it with your account. So the item name, I'm going to put the name of the person. I've selected my board. I'm going to select my group ID, which is going to be new leads. And then right here, I'm going to create the columns that I want to add to Monday. So here's our connection text. This is what we're going to use for our note when we connect to this person in LinkedIn. Now I have a replace function here, and I know ChatGPT likes to add lots of new lines and that kind of thing. So I'm going to remove those new lines. I want it all in one line and just add a space into that. So that's what this replace function is doing. So I need to go find my message. Right there. So there's my content. It's going to remove new lines and put a space. And then after that, I'm hard coding. I help entrepreneurs add automation to their business, and I'd like to connect. That sounds familiar. All right. So let's go to our next tab. We're going to add an item here, and we're going to do status. And the status is a label, and we want new lead. We're going to add a new item here. I'm going to do full intro text. This is named kind of funny because I originally named it for a different purpose. Basically, I'm going to put in here the headline, the about information, basically the raw information that we're using to create that customized ChatGPT connection note. I just want to have it handy in case I need to look at it and rewrite something. So I'm going to put the headline in there and do a hard return and do the about. Next, I'm going to put the source of this. And I'm going to choose the label LinkedIn search. That is my Monday piece of things. I'm going to auto align. I'm going to save. So I've gone to another profile here, and let's go and click Bardeen and click our playbook link. And there's Valerie. She's been added. All right, so I'm going to go through my process with you. Normally, I would have more leads on here built up. I try to send 25 or 30 a day. just so I don't raise any issues with LinkedIn, but that's still a significant amount. And then managing the responses and the back and forth chat that happens from that is plenty for me. So I'm going to go through here. And what I do is I right click on and copy the cell in Monday. And then I'm going to click to visit the LinkedIn profile. Now I'm going to go right here to connect, add a note, and then I'm going to paste that in there. And you can see we are under the limit, which is good. So I just like to give it a look. This is really the first time I've seen this note, and give it a quick read. This is really well done. I like how it reads, and it makes good sense. So I'm going to hit send to connect to Philip Lakin. I actually know Philip Lakin already, and I want to tell you how I know him. I know Philip through his NoCode Ops community. If you're an operations professional, then the NoCode Ops community is for you. I want to personally invite you to join the community. You can apply to join, and on that application, please tell them that Andy O'Neill sent you. I hope to see you inside the NoCode Ops community. Now, I have another video you might be interested in. It involves LinkedIn automation, and it's where I take RSS feeds and I post them to LinkedIn using ChatGPT to rewrite those articles. This video I just recommended is the top video on my channel of all time, and you might have an interest in it too. I'll see you next time.